都在花莲，
teams,
路途真的遥远，
yeah,
又因为地震要来一趟，也真不容易。所以全部科技接轨力量加成，教育现场希望绽放。那在这边 ，OK， 这边可以哦。我们看一下，今天要上线的是我们慈济大学国际学院的助理教授，
okay.
而且今天这一堂课哦，连我
都非常好奇， Today we have this sister
老师如何
from Suji University International College. She's a teacher. She's a teacher, associate professor from the International College of Suji University, and she's a director of Chinese Character Society and a convener of the Early Childhood Humanities Chinese Language Education Program. She is a sister, Lu Peishan. Now let us look into Suji University International College have many programs on. Recently, there are many active programs on. Now, let us look at this video. It's about these tools, toe separator, to let the people who have toes problems. So, Suji International College, the students have invented this two separator to benefit, strengthen the muscles of the people who have two problems. There are many activities and programs by Suji University International College. Many of them are innovative and creative. And they have made many innovations and great to benefit in shop to the world. Now this is another video is talking about the teacher students marathon run up exercise. So early morning, there are some students come together with their teachers to join this jogging marathon. This is the first time that she joined this. Joining this marathon, and this is the first time that the teacher and students are doing together. So I'm very happy that our teacher is accompanying us in this marathon and jogging from one from beginning to the finishing point. Today, we have a sister location. We have seen her in two videos. She has the affinity to her home brother is involved in the Suji University and is a principal there. Suji University International College is now known as a Suji International Technology College and has attracted many students. This is home brother, Lu Peishan, when she graduated and had been involved. When he first joined this Suji International College, and this is the first job that sister Lu Peishan. And now, she has come back to the Suji University International College to provide her service and expertise. No matter where it is, she's still within the Suji University College campuses. So teachers and students, they run for the 10 kilometer to exercise the perseverance and endurance. So our teacher is coming here today to tell her story. Just now we saw her. That's we saw her that she's running with her students for a 10 kilometer. Have you ever run a 10 kilometer marathon? Usually, I have not run for 10 kilometer, but I'm always the cheerleader, the sign to give confidence, cheering the people who are participating in the marathon run. We are grateful to our sister, Peishan, and appreciate and cherish her affinity with us. Sister Lu Peishan. This is the right video. Thank you, Sister Peishan. Anyone, sorry?
等一下，我等一下要处理一下。 请玉清，马来西亚的玉清师姐， 你的分享简报一定要收掉， 要不然的话我们， 老师的简报没办法。
Kindly, sister from Malaysia, Li Yiqing, can you take temporarily take away your the poster, the PPT, because it has covered up the sister Lu Peishan sharing now.
你不小心你的简报没有收掉，你分享简报没收掉，我们下面的讲师完全没办法那个，你赶快收掉你的分享。收掉了，收掉了。好，收掉了，谢谢。好，来，佩珊，麻烦您分享简报。
You can now start and share your PPT now.
Everyone,
now it's on. Everybody can see it clearly. 亲爱的商人，金师师傅，全球经济家人，以及高雄的乡亲，大家好。过去是慈济大学，国际学院计划领域。Brother and sisters and family members, and all the students and the teachers, good day to you. Many of the students of Khao Mi teachers Chan Shan. I'm very happy to meet you on the night today, and I'm very grateful to Sister Teacher Mei Yin and Kao Chung Book Club for the invitation. Myself, Peishan, a personal major in ancient character with teacher. The video that have been put up just now was about 6 years ago. Since age 20, I'm involved in the world of ancient writing, and I have already accumulated more than 20 years experience, and I would like to share. I've accumulated dozens of volumes of Winters and Summers write up about ancient writing. Today, I want to share the experience with my limited insight over the years. Today is September 21, 91. The earthquake many years ago shattered campuses and families, but we Taiwanese people have shown resilience to our lives. And research people also have shown, courageously shown love and caring for others. Though we were affected by the earthquake 921 years ago, therefore today I would like to share with you my life experience that I have learned from ancient writing. The Chinese character that we use every day is a typical living fossil. It is about 4,000 years old and is still widely used today. Today we will take a look at the cultural quotes revealed by these ancient characters, philosophy, which dictates the principles of being a human. Mankind is most a special species on earth, and our ancient wise men say that man is only a little bit different from other things. What is this little difference about? Good. Teacher Sunshine is coming to test everyone. Please guess, what are these words? Welcome to Reply Online. I can see you. These are big. These words are big. Can you see the line at one? So the line you can see denotes that it's a plot of land. Oftentimes that we start from nothing, like such a plot sketch from the earth, and it gives rise to life. Many people now this have grown into a carrot, white carrot.
他用他旺盛的生命力告诉我们生命的奇迹。
All these various texts, creatures would correspond to one word, and various forms of people are correspond to different characters. Man is a different, a special species of earth, because people have many different possibilities, capabilities. There's only a slight difference, a little difference between man and other creatures. Teacher Sunshine would like to test you all today. What do you see here? What are these words? All these words are connected with men, with people. Let us look at it one by one.
这第一个呢是正面站着的人。
The first one is a person.
第二个呢是侧面的人。
The other person is a sign.
第三个是跪坐着的女性。
It's about a person, a female, a child, a mother, a husband.
这个举着双手头发有点乱的是用来表示顺从的意思。
There's another one that shows that it's a, it looks a very comical and funny. Actually, everyone has a different facial features. It's just like a small child. So another of this photo you can see is a little bit elderly who needs a walking stick to walk on.
我们出门呢，一定会把头发整理好，把头发竖起来。
And then that one is about more similar to people in Suji who would take care of yourself neatly whenever they are going out. The ancient people are very envious of this kind of people. They carry a lot of clothes on their back. Why? Because people have many different capabilities and possibilities. Master always reminds us not to underestimate our own potential. Everyone has his own potential and capabilities. Like myself, I'm a person, I'm also a female, I'm also a mother to three person, to other three child, I'm a mother to three children. We have to look carefully at ourselves, understand ourselves, know ourselves better.
接下来我们来看这个人。Let
us look at this person.
古代人呢, 我们的祖先们很羡慕这种人。这个人的身上呢，背了满满的禾，禾是稻米谷类，可以背在身上。These
ancient person are very special people, able to carry a lot of grains on their back. And it denotes that it's a year of a bountiful harvest year, and they have able to indicate that they have many rice and grains for the year. It's a good harvest for the whole year. The harvest year is not easy to come by, and it's only achieved through hard work and irrigation every day. Although it's very tough, but it's most joyful because of the bountiful load of harvest. Master always tell us that tree. Always tell us to take inventory of the value of our life, and as at the end of each year, we should recall what we have gained and reflect what we have experienced during the past year. Next are two words. Both of these words are the same. Come and guess.
Can.
There are two footprints to indicate the left feet and left feet and right feet. Use two footprints to indicate the meaning of walking with the left foot and the right foot. So the footsteps that we do not need to stop at the same place, because the footsteps are to step out boldly. We should not. Our footstep doesn't confine us to remain at the same place. We have to step the first step forward with the first step. We can see that baby's first step in life means that to show that they can control their action without being carried around or hold on to. The same is true for doing things. The first step in every journey is to step out and do it right. We all have seen all these kind of people, and now let us take a look at the philosophy of life and the principles of being a person. Now that we have stepped boldly and courageously step out of our comfort zone, now we can see these are four lines. It's a broad path. Can you guess what word is it? It's about. It's sing, means it's action. This word is very simple, and I believe everyone of us know it. It's by our ancient philosopher Lao Tzu that this is the origin of all things. Okay, when we are taking the first step briefly and put heart with our hearts and eyes and to know where we are going to. It's a beautiful word. Sing is action. It's a road that extends to all directions, much like our current crossroads. In fact, life is a journey. No matter how much we have or how many things we achieve, it is still the end of a person's journey towards life. Speaking of walking, I want to share with you that when Master came to Kaohsiung in 2009, having a warm session with Suji people, Master taught us to walk the right way. There are many roads, and all roads lead to Rome. But we have the choice to choose the right way, not the fast way, so that we can control our life. Now you can see that the characters, the ancient characters, are about the hands. Here, the hand, and then we have the picture of a person walking on the road of life. Many people, many things cannot be mastered, but we can use our hands, our pair of hands, to control where we're holding to and what we're holding. One hand, we can hold on to a pencil or to books or to any documents. There are many hands here, holding different things in the hands, such as the pen, books, brooms, and sticks. You and I can't change other people, but we ourselves can decide what things to hold in our hands tightly. Just like our pair of hands can help to do for the environment protection, and we can use our pair of hands to do recycling.
So,
the most beautiful pair of hands that, like now, our recycling and cycling volunteers' hands are the most beautiful because they help to save the earth, doing a lot for eco-saving the earth. After we have decided what to hold tightly in our hand, we can walk the road with a peace, peacefully, and with a cool mind.
手里拿着工具就到了狱里当为当地付出。
Walking and walk, you often encounter people and organizations with different ideas from other own. And we may accidentally follow the bad people, may go astray. Is there anything to avoid? Let us take a look at the word then. If we are not careful, we may go astray and follow the bad guys.
So,
is there anything to avoid? Let us take a look at the word then. The two on the left are tripods. Follow a modern tripod and then make it a new tripod. This is the rule. There are two ways of writing. The ancient people took this word as the principle of the principle, that is to say that it tells us that the principle is not only about thinking about ourselves, we must also have a model and a framework for doing things. Not only thinking about ourselves, but doing things according to our ideal. Our ideas. So you can see this tripod with a three legs supporting it. The top, ancient characters will tell us that we should always consider where is the point of consideration and coming to a consensus. Don't the ancient people take this word as a principle of a principle and is to caution us to be careful with our thoughts. Also to caution us that we have to use a model and follow an exemplary model and it's a principle. We must uphold the principle of honesty and sincerity, and this is the principle of being a person. Like what Master always tells us, being a suchi people, we hold on to the principle of sincerity and integrity. If we do things with principles, we will not fail. How is possible? Okay, we will still encounter setbacks. So you see these two pictures? So we see that at the bottom that there's a person on top and underneath is like a sugar cane. It's a cane, gan. In addition to this, the purpose of life is so very important. So if we look at this word, there is a purpose. There's a person here, and below there's a person with a sweet cane. What does it mean? One of the things that make us feel sweet and beautiful. Ancient people tell us that the purpose is to be simple, that is to do things mindfully with our heart and our mind, and do something that will make us happy and smile sweetly. This is the purpose of life. If you find such a thing and I can feel the joy in it, that is the right thing. Though it's not easy to do it. Therefore, we must hold on to our principles in life and do things that are with a meaningful purpose and value in life. Sometimes we work the whole day, we may feel very tired after a whole day's work, like coming to school. Of course, there will be troubles and worries in our happy life, but let us take a closer look at this. As long as we are doing things, there are always setbacks in life. How do we address the setback? So many of the students always say that, you know, we are a failure if we are not doing things well. So in ancient character writing,
是拿着棍子, 我们刚刚看过这个字, 拿着棍子呢,
ancient character writing,
毁坏了这个顶。那这个呢, 第三个呢, 是拿着棍子, 毁坏了贝壳的贝。 顶跟贝呢, 在古代都是很珍贵的宝器。 这个是古人写失败的败, 是用
No, this is
the
ancient character being drawn by our ancient people in the old days. So let us understand actually what is failure.
其实从古文字来看, 人生真正的失败是故意, 毁坏对你来说,
in my teaching career, I found that some children
get
repeated the same problem,
拿着棍棒把宝器毁坏了,
and everyone reminded that it's been ineffective. 如果你是一步一脚印, about a different situation.
它经常重复出现相同的问题, 身边的人,
we take a look at this animated character and guess the word.
This is Shen.
A person who's sitting on his knees with
her
eyes indicate the person is looking in his eyes.
左边的上面的这个字, 好,
how has such a person ever really appeared?
有一个房间,
guess the word.
好,
is it real?
房间里面呢, 有一只手拿着棍子, 好, 对着一个人, 还在打人。
In this in the room, we can see that.
下面这个字, 同样也是拿着棍子,
look at the word, the picture below. We can see that the word below is a man holding a stick at the child next to him. Well, the first one, the word above is that there is a person in a room beating the people with a stick. So, guess what these two words mean? The above is the thief who bullies. They are bullies. And the bottom is the teacher who teaches the student. You should hold on the same stick and change it into a completely different perspective and different person. Life is always also often due to some small changes that may bring us different effects of the situation. Let's look at this animated character and guess the word. This is a person who is sitting on his knees with an eye. A person with a big eye. Can you imagine what word is that?
我们来看看,
let us see.
这个字呢, 是见, 看见的见, 文字当中写的这个样子, 好, 有一个跪坐的人,
you can see.
他搭配了一双,
you can see the things. There are many truths that cannot be seen by eyes in the ancient text. This denotes that the person is using her eyes to see.
真实地出现过吗? 看见的见。
Can we,
oh,
there are many people who have many truths that cannot be seen by eyes in the ancient text, such as this word. A man who runs hard, to emphasize that the man runs fast, he even drew 3 feet. He drew 3 feet. Such a person used to be a real. Has there been any person with 3 feet? So it looks like it's the word should be a running man. A man who runs very fast, who put in a lot of effort to emphasize that this man runs so fast because he has this extra 3 feet. Extra 1 feet. Does this kind of man exist? Therefore, ancient people tell us that through ancient texts that the truth is not to see with the eyes. The most subtle truth needs to be felt, need to be filled with the heart, and the truth could be right in front of us.
还是用后世的角度创造了这个字。一个人的身体里面
住着
一个小宝宝。
Ancient,
这个就是孕，怀孕的孕。
I would like to share with you. Oh, this is a person that pregnant.
我想跟大家分享
to the very last, I would like to share one word with you.
这个字的左边
to the left,
左边这里我们又看到了眼睛，我们刚刚有看过
to the left, then we saw
下面这里呢
that's an eye.
这个部分呢是心
and below, that is a heart.
这个字呢就是我们经常写的哲学家的哲。在古代呢
In ancient days, the ancient used the eye to carefully observe the world and the heart to feel the world with the heart. We need to use our heart
to feel. 其实目在这里呢，是表示古人认为哲学家就是要
Our heart can, ancient people also feel that.
是要仔细用眼睛去。
Think also can mean the mind.And the heart as well. To be able to use both the mind and the heart is important because we do, it's not enough to only use the eyes to see. We have used the mind together to feel. And that's what our ancient philosopher have taught us. The word
the
awareness.
大家都要心眼并用，祝福大家都是
一个有智慧的哲人哲学
家。我今天的分享呢就到此，非常非常感恩大家。
Reminds me of to be a meditative. If we can use our heart, the truth is really in front of us. If we don't have our heart, the truth is very far away. So we have to use our ears to do both jobs.
我们这边有一个书友啊，啊，燕美，你是高雄的家人。他说，在文字中见证生命力，希望绽放。透过今天的高雄线上读书
，Teacher
Kate
Peishan, that is a question.
所以非常的感恩哈。其实大家在看的时候，我刚才比如说，我有个问题哦，就是这些古文字你看得懂
？All these ancient characters.
你平常写吗？
All these ancient characters, when we look at it, we can we understand it. But do we need to use? Do we need to write this?
Or
does the teacher Peishan you write it using these drawings? Using these ancient characters?
都是非常象形，很适合大家初学者一起来学。欢迎大家有机会一起来学古文字。
I welcome everyone to come on board to.
那个棍子，它放在
不能
自如。一般我们棍子就拿就一根嘛。在古文字里的棍子还蛮奇特，画了一个这样子，非常有意思哈。那我还有一个小小的家里
，was carrying a stick。
你跟你们家，你很喜欢让我们猜字，你跟你们家师兄会这样写一个字让他猜
一下吗？let us guess the words.
我们在做学问讨论的时候也会，就是其实我家师兄是我的学长，所以其实在我刚进入到这个学术殿堂的时候，有很多时候是他带着我一起进的，是非常好的学习学术上的伴侣。
My home brother is my companion, always a good companion in learning all these ancient characters.
学长，现在变成菩萨道侣，而且刚才你还说，跟着家里的三个孩子，我们听到三个孩子眼睛都一亮亮的，就觉得好感动。
We are so surprised that you have
your
is your mother of three children.
他的孩子是非常非常的优秀哈，所以我们长春的刘春枝就
说，
慈济大学
的children, three children are very
well
groomed.
中华古文意非凡，生命教育志中涵，赞叹师姐有智慧，中华文化来传。
We have feedbacks from
我们。
That teacher Peishan are very wise.
Have good wisdom.
All these ancient characters writings You just need a lot,
时间你会不会哪一天就来一个古文字也说一说 他每一个月上来的主题就让我们非常的这样期待哈。然后这边的
We are looking forward to teacher Peishan for future
回应我们的吕老师他说文字蕴含智慧不分古今承载生命教育当属中华口齿清晰博学多闻温婉柔美的佩珊
师姐 all the feedback from brothers and sisters regarding teacher Peishan's sister Peishan's sharing just now about ancient character
人师难求良师兴国您的学生得遇良师实在是太幸福了那诗经说我没有论文可以写不就是不需要古文字了吗学古文的目的到底是什么呢老师请回答
What's the objective for studying ancient characters? There's a question from the sisters and other feedback.
像埃及文都差不多时候一起出现，可是埃及文已经死掉了。现在的埃及人不用埃及古文字，可是我们用，我们只是转了一些面貌。文字是跟着我们，跟着时代一起在转变。
Oh, ancient characters are actually
有点变了。
Is following times as time change, so that will be a little changes to all these Chinese language education program.
有时候也会常常跟我们说这个皈依，这个反黑归白。其实这些都是从文字当中崛起。
Just like Master always tell us that we change.
虽然现在我们不用古文字，
we change the black to white.
深刻的理念还是值得我们用心去挖掘。它就像一个文化宝藏。
Actually, this is a very rich cultural heritage and that we should cherish it and
be preserved.
So,
feedbacks
from around the world actually they are also equally talented with all their feedbacks.
那同时呢，刚才的学育的一个导读也是非常多人上线留言哦。那日本的金辉说，感恩学育师姐的导读，师徒因缘最经典的画面。
Yes, we are grateful to Sister 学育 for your sharing just now. And these are the comments left on Facebook. The positive comments.